So this morning I check my email and I see a press release from Warner Brothers saying, "Oh my God, Harley and Deadshot from Suicide Squad have joined Injustice 2." And I had gotten a similar press release for when they joined the Injustice 2 mobile app, which was pretty good. Good enough that I decided to watch the trailer that accompanied the press release. And when I did, showing some gameplay for these Suicide Squad skins, I was incredibly impressed. And I was like, where's this in the movies? And then, as we do on YouTube, I saw a little thumbnail for a Wonder Woman Blue Beetle. Blue Beetle, of course, not in the movies yet. But I was like, let me check that trailer out. And I was like, oh my God, this is so good too. And it really highlights a problem that Warner Brothers has with their movies, and I think is one of the most common complaints that we can all agree with when it comes to the DCEU, and that's not enough action, which is so weird because they have such good action in their video games. So we're actually going to go through those two trailers in just a moment, but allow me first to walk you through my thought process. All right, so anyway, again, as I said, one of the well, actually, the better place to start is that let's give DC the recognition it deserves for really doing a fabulous job in every area, kind of but comics and movies, right? Their animation's pretty darn good. Well, they faltered with the Killing Joke, but still, overall, very good reputation there. And also, their video games are spectacular. In fact, Marvel, it's like the inverse situation there. Marvel really can't even get on the board when it comes to video games, whereas I think it might actually currently be DC's strongest division. Yet they continue to ignore the talent that they're cultivating there. And some of that talent even ended up going to Marvel. Well, Marvel at Fox, but I'm getting ahead of myself. But anyway, again, one of the major complaints about the DCEU is lack of action. Even though I love Batman v Superman, I agree, could have used more action, especially for a movie that is billed as a fight. And then I thought that Suicide Squad had a real lack of action, and also underpowered characters, which you're going to see fixed with the Injustice 2 trailers. But I would like to say that Man of Steel, as I'm sure some of you have already typed, Man of Steel had very good action. And it's weird also that Zack Snyder movies wouldn't have enough action, because that's one of like the best things, if not the best things, that he does. But I thought the Feyora fight sequence with Superman in Smallville was on Smallville Main Street was great. I mean, even with the really obvious product placement, it was still amazing. In fact, I went to see that movie twice because it came out for Father's Day, as you might recall. So I saw the press screening, and then I went with my own father for Father's Day, and I was looking forward the most to seeing that fight sequence, and it did not disappoint in round two. But anyway, speaking of action, Captain America: Civil War, of course, has famously, or infamously, if you're a hardcore DC fan, you know, if you're one of those that chooses sides, I think we should get over that. But anyway, infamously beat out Batman v Superman at the box office. Captain America: Civil War is a billion-dollar picture, and in my review of Captain America: Civil War, I said that it has the best action sequences, and I still feel this way, of any recent superhero movie. I mean, they're really, really good. That airport battle alone is amazing, and actually is kind of like something that you would see in a video game. But it's very, very good, very inventive, very funny, and again, great action. And it also reminds me of something that Steven Soderbergh said that I've brought up to you guys a couple of times if you're a regular BTT viewer. And that's that Soderbergh was lamenting that he was in the airport and he saw a male in his 30s, and he said that's the target demographic for Hollywood, basically, watching a movie on his laptop. And he's like, I'm gonna go do some research and see what he's watching. So Steven Soderbergh spied on this guy and was like, he's watching an action movie, and even more than that, like a blockbuster, he's fast-forwarding through all the dialogue and just going to the action sequences. And while Steven Soderbergh was appalled, that's a very important lesson for the comic book movie filmmakers to understand. Something the Russo brothers understand. I mean, there are a lot of great action sequences in Captain America: Civil War. You could totally watch it that way. And I hope you'll watch it with me live when I do on September 2nd, when the movie becomes available digitally. Make sure you follow me on Twitter for reminders, but that will happen 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I will watch the movie live on YouTube, and if you queue up the movie at the same time, we can watch together. I did that for Batman v Superman. But anyway, There, you can't really do that with Batman v Superman. My favorite scene in Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice is when they're all at Lex's party in their alter egos, because I feel it's very James Bondy. But, you know, the repeatability on that isn't as big as, of course, the airport battle sequence. So this is something that DC should fix, and they have some wonderful action already available for us to enjoy in their video games. I mean, they have the way they utilize these characters is spectacular. So they've already lost Tim Miller. Tim Miller directed the DC Universe Online trailer, which was one of the most amazing things ever made. And he actually met with DC, said about doing a Lobo movie, but it just didn't come together. So he went and made Deadpool, which had great action. In fact, that was one of the best parts of the movie, particularly the first 20 minutes. Incredibly inventive. And one of my biggest requests for Deadpool 2 is more flippy. I said it was flippy because I love the way he flipped around and did somersaults in midair. It was so cool. Very video game like. I want more of that in the sequel. So Tim Miller gets it, but he no longer is a DC talent. Now, with Injustice 2, the director here is actually Ed Boon. And Ed Boon co-created Mortal Kombat. So he knows a thing or two about awesome fight sequences and also setting characters up. I mean, a lot of this is like the characters you're going to see posturing, and that's important. And I think that they could use a little bit of that, more of that in the DCEU. So I'd be like, hey, Ed Boon, why don't you come at least consult or become my second unit director on a big Hollywood movie? Because these Ed Boon and his team are using the skins from the movies and they're doing a better job with them. Now, to be fair, I feel that every actor who's currently cast in the DCEU could pull these moves off easily, and the dialogue that they're given. I can't show the dialogue because of fair use laws, but I'm gonna tell you some of my favorite lines as we watch. And I have links down below to the actual trailers if you'd like to watch them all the way through with the volume. But anyway, I feel that the actors could do all of this easily, and so that really falls on the directors, the writers, and the producers, who should say to the directors and writers, why aren't you doing this? All right, so let's take a look. I'm so excited. It's so good. All right, so first up, Harley, who is particularly well done. And also, I have to say, the DCEU is very strong in their female characters. The casting, I think, has been excellent with Gal Gadot and Margot Robbie. And the video games here use them really well. So that's really exciting. All right, so let's take a look at Harley. It's so good. Oh, I'm so excited. All right, so nice little intro. The new DC logo, by the way, is growing on me. All right. So now right here, I want to stop for a second. I think that the hyenas are a great choice. Oh, she needs those in the movies right away. And you can see with the movie skin, they've given them the colored hair. I don't think they had that. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Maybe in one comic or the other, they might have shown it. But it's a great addition. You know, the Joker and Harley use a lot of hair dye. And it looks fantastic. So I love this. I think that's great. So here's her intro. And the acting on this, the character is great. So the exchange here, so let's just go through the exchange. The exchange is, he says, Harleen, you're losing control. And I love this. She says, it's part of my charm. That's a great line. That's like, I don't think she had hardly any good lines like that in Suicide Squad. If I were Margot Robbie, I'd be like, get me the writer of Injustice 2 to at least come in here and pepper the script with some better one-liners. I also think that this leather jacket, I like this a little bit better than the motorcycle jacket that she, the character has. And I think the goggles are cool too. It's really great. It's a good a combination of what we've seen in the comics and the video games and in the movie. And it's just spectacular. All right, so look at this. Unpredictable, yeah. This is great. She's like, stop trying to kill me. Now, this is important. Now, watch her beat the crap out of Wonder Woman with her baseball bat. This is a juiced up Harley. And, you know, I really had a problem with the lack of powers in Suicide Squad. They seemed like, as I said in my review, any bunch of criminals you could have sent out into Midway City to take care of. Well, I don't want to give any spoilers away in case you haven't seen Suicide Squad yet, but it could have been any group of convicts, basically. They need to juice up their Suicide Squad characters. And maybe, you know, if Poison Ivy does join the sequel, she can juice up Harley then. But I think that Harley becomes a lot more fun when she is someone who is a little bit more superpowered. You know, she doesn't have to be like a Superman level, but just a little bit more. So look at this. I love the way she first beats up Wonder Woman, but then look at the way she does like a little move at the end, a little signature thing. It's very good. So there, beats the crap out of her. Oh, that's, yeah, she like, you know, does like a vaudeville exit. Perfect. More of that, please. It's very, very clever. Now, I think that these costumes are good, but then this one looks horrible. That's really bad. I think that does not work, and I think that the Jester costume just doesn't work for some reason in live action. So I like the multicolored pigtails. I think they're cool. And I was, there she said, like, again, that was good. And then you see with the mallet and everything, again, superpower. Now here she says, snack time, boys. And I think that's great. See, you can see her using the hyenas. It just gives her a little bit more to do and makes her seem a little bit more, not only colorful, but more like a comic book character, right? All right, so that's great. I love that. I think that's so good. And then here they're going to, so that's good. So then they're going to have, so Deadshot's going to come in. And I like when she says, ready for some slapstick. That's fantastic. That's such a great line. I mean, the double meaning there is great because, of course, not only is she going to slap him around in a minute, although it doesn't go that way, as you're about to see, but slapstick, of course, is, again, a comedy term. So it's really good. It's really, really good. And this talent is all just sitting in the Warner Brothers, they all are on the Warner Brothers payroll. Now here, Deadshot doesn't have a lot to say, although they seem to have made him, he seems not like Will Smith here, which I find weird. I don't know if what ethnicity they've decided to do, but look at that. That was so cool. I mean, like, Will Smith, again, he too should be like, why don't I have more cool scenes like this where I get to show off my cool powers? That's great. Really, really well done. Okay, so I think that, so as you can see, that's just a couple of minutes of action here. This trailer is only like under a minute and a half and more action than I think in a lot of Suicide Squad, right? And great one-liners. Now look at this Wonder Woman one. Oh, so good. All right, so here comes Wonder Woman. I like she says, your mind tricks won't work on me. And he's like, I'll just have to use strength. And then she's like, I'm an Amazon. The face looks horrible on that for some reason. I don't know why the face looks so bad. It doesn't look nearly as good. It really looks plastered on there. And the hair is weird, too. Wonder Woman doesn't look as good as the Harley Quinn one. But the action is spectacular. And she has some good lines as well that I think is very, very good. All right, so she's going to beat the crap out of Gorilla Grodd. Love it. Love the use of brute strength. Look at that. And so I love the way she uses the lasso here. It's so cool. Although, to be fair, in the trailer that we've seen so far for Wonder Woman, also very good use of the lasso of truth, which maybe needs a new name. I think this is great when she says, here she's saying, submit to me. Great Wonder Woman line. I think it works really well with the character and her Amazonian heritage, but it doesn't go too far. It's just perfect, actually. I love it. It's funny, when I said the trailer, I said she's fighting with Christmas lights, and there are some Christmas lights on the wall back there. That's funny. All right, so anyway, that's great. Now here, now this is great. Look at that. Uses the leg. Oh my God, it's amazing. It's so cool. Now this is so great. Hold on, look at this. I was just going to say, if I was Gal Gadot, I'd be like, why didn't I see this before I made our movie? Should we do some reshoots? God, no. Don't get that rumor started for Wonder Woman. You'll just have to save it for the sequel or Justice League. Now look at this. I love banging the shield. That's right out of like a 300 movie or something. It's great. Now look at that. Now the problem is she doesn't really fly. I mean, she can leap, but she's not going to be able to hover like that in any of the movies. But you can see it really helps with her action sequences. But so good. And again, Warner Brothers has this talent on the payroll, and I don't understand why. I mean, they should not have a lack of action in their movies. They have some of the best characters, archetypes in comics who can do great action. They know they have people working for them who can do it, who can execute it in a visual format like a movie. So there's no excuse at this point for the DCEU to be so light on action. And I think that if they fix that problem, that'll go a long way to fixing their box office problem because they'll really increase their the rewatchability of their movies. All right, so that's my thoughts on the DCEU versus the DC video games. I'm curious to hear what you think with this new perspective, and what do you think of the way these Injustice 2 is handling the DCEU's own characters. All right, write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some more coverage right now.